our Lord invites to his table all who love him, who earnestly repent of their sin and seek to live in peace with one another. Therefore, let us confess our sin before God and one another. Let us pray together. Merciful God, we confess that we have not loved you with our whole heart. We have failed to be an obedient church. We have not done your will. We have broken your law. We have rebelled against your love. We have not loved our neighbors, and we have not heard the cry of the needy. Forgive us, we pray. Free us for joyful obedience through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear now the good news. Christ died for us while we were yet sinners. That proves God's love toward us. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven. Glory to God.
Amen. Now, as God's forgiven and reconciled people, let us offer one another signs of reconciliation and love. Let's pass the peace of Christ with one another, and our offering plates will also be coming on, and we will be presenting our offering this morning, too.
Mostly it's my children. Could I have, my children, would you come forward? And you want to come? Come on. Don't want to put you on the spot, bud. All right. Isaac drove Louise to church today. I believe it. He might need a block underneath his foot, though. Hey, safe driver. I believe it. All right, hey, buddy, we're going to do the best we can today. That's what we're going to do. So, do you know what today is?
It's Holy Day.
It's what?
It's Sunday.
Oh, it's Sunday?
Yeah.
Sunday. It's Sunday. It is. Hey, buddy. Do you know, Isaac, do you know what day it is?
Isaac's like, yes, 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 Pastor Susanna. It's New Year's Day. That's, oh, no, those are glasses. Oh, no.
Oh,
it is New Year's Day, and today we start all over again. And look at all these adults. All these adults here have decided that this year is the year that they make their beds when they wake up. Or that they're going to lose 10 pounds. Or stop eating out so much. Or what else, guys? Anything else? Yeah? Yeah? Well, today is a brand new day. And like any day, it's the day that the Lord has made. So let us rejoice and be glad in it. And all of us are going to make plans for our new year. But what I want you to do today is I printed out a picture of a church. And I want you, Owen. I want you to draw what you think our church is going to look like this year. So is it, are there going to be a lot of people here? Are there going to be flowers?
No.
No flowers. Is there going to be cake?
No.
No cake. Well, what's going to be at our church this year?
Cake.
Cake. Oh, all kinds of things. So during service today, I want you to draw, and you can write if you don't want to draw, to say what our church is going to look like by the, Poppy, he's coming your way, by the end of the year. And we're going to see if that, we're going to see if that happens. He's going to play. All right, you know what? While he plays us a tune, let's go on and have a word of prayer, all right? All right, let's you pray with me, baby. Yes, thank you, God, for a new year. And thank you that we get to live into this new year and dream about who you're going to call us to be and call us to love this year. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Would you be interested? You don't have to. Easy, nah, nah, nah. You know, maybe some of our adults will. Would you take that back to Gigi? Yeah? Would you take that back to Gigi? Yeah? All right. Thank you for coming forward, Isaac. That was, and thank you for driving Luis here today. That's very important. All right. Thank you, Tolbert Clam and Isaac. All right.
Our scripture lesson this morning comes from the book of Revelation. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth. For the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. And I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of the heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "See, the home of God is among mortals. He will dwell with them as their God. They will be his peoples, and God himself will be with them. He will wipe every tear from their eyes. Death will be no more. Mourning and crying and pain will be no more, for the first things have passed away." And the one who was seated on the throne said, "See, I am making all things new." Also he said, "Write this, for these words are trustworthy and true." Then he said to me, "It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end." This is the word of God for us, the people of God. Thanks be to God. Let us go to God in prayer. Heavenly Father, we pray that the things that bind us, for the hurts, the unmet needs, God, the resentments, the anxieties, Father God, we pray that you would help us release them now, that we would be able to be present with you here in our hearts and in our minds. Father God, as we know that you are making all things new, remind us today that today, like any other day, is a good day to worship you and to be with you. Now I invite you to pray for me and with me, that may the words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts be acceptable in thy sight, that all that we do, God, be to the glory of you and to you alone. In your name we pray. Amen. It was many years ago, I will not say how many, but I was awful young, and now as a parent, this story terrifies me. But I was awful young, and first year of college, and spending J term in Paris, France. J term is January, one class for the month, and at that ripe young age, me and a group of seven other young ladies, we would have behaved much better if one male had been in attendance, I do believe, but there were none to be had. Seven young ladies moved to Paris without much supervision. Terrifying now as a parent. Terrifying as a parent. But our first night there, we've moved into our little apartments, our little hostel, and out of one of our friends' windows, we see the Eiffel Tower. Oh, it's sparkling and beautiful. And we decide in our youth, we're going to go see the Eiffel Tower right now after flying all the way here. So we bundle up. It is January 6th, Epiphany. We bundle up. There's 2 inches of ice on all of the sidewalks. Most of the places are closed. It is late at night. We decide, a city that is much bigger than Colonial Heights, that we are going to walk in the direction of the Eiffel Tower. And oh, we are joyful. We're a clan of joyful little things. We're going to go see the Eiffel Tower. It's going to be everything we ever dreamed of. It sparkles on the hour. Look at the light shining. We're going to go, and it's going to be beautiful. And Toulouse-Lautrec is going to be underneath painting, and the can-can dancers, and crepes, and everyone will be wearing berets, and it'll be wonderful, and there will be chocolate. And 2.5 hours later, we are lost. I didn't tell you this story. You don't need to. Don't worry about it. I thought about sharing a map, but I didn't want you to know how lost your pastor was. We are in this part of the city. The Eiffel Tower is in this part of the city. We have made it this part of the city. You can still see the Eiffel Tower. But 2.5 hours trekking in the cold, in the dark, without cell phones, it was the year 2009, without cell phones, without a metro card, without a map, we have found ourselves in front of Notre Dame Cathedral, literally the centerpiece of the city. There is an emblem there that you are standing in the middle of the city. We are further away from the Eiffel Tower than we were 2.5 hours beforehand. Praise be to God, you run into an American who's lived in Paris for 10 years, and he goes, "You look lost," and he puts us on a metro back. I can promise you that trip, we ran into many a cowboy with a cowboy hat who said, "Oh no, let me put you back where you're supposed to go." But in our youthfulness and in our excitement, we saw this beautiful, bright, shining thing in the distance, right? Couldn't wait till daylight. Couldn't wait. Had to go. It was going to be everything we ever dreamed Paris would be, right? It's not. But it was going to be. And we were giggling and joyful and slipping on ice and just, you know, living the dream. We're going to make it. And, you know, I imagine that the Magi, who on January 6th, when we celebrate Epiphany, these wise people from far away are following this bright, shining thing in the distance. And, you know, I doubt it was 2 inches of ice. But they trek out, and they had maps, thankfully. And you know, hopefully they met some friendly people with cowboy hats along the way who told them which way to go. Herod, not one of them. He was not helpful. But they trek out. Because this thing in the distance, this bright, beautiful thing, and it's going to be everything that they dreamed of, right? They're going to go find God. And they get lost along the way. And they run into bullies. And depending on what version of claymation you have watched, the camels may or may not have been singing. You know, they get there years later. And I wonder if, like a bunch of youngsters in Paris, if they finally got there and it wasn't exactly what they thought it was going to be. You find Mary and Joseph, these nobodies, with a child. You've come from Herod, who is evil and going to murder children. And you've gone all this way, and your best hope is in a child. It's pretty frightening. Our text this morning from Revelation is talking to people who have experienced Jesus. They have followed the star. They have found Emmanuel, God with us. They are people who have walked with God in the flesh. They have eaten with him. They have done Passover with him. They have walked the fields. They have argued with Pharisees. They have gone to temple with him. They have lived life with this man. And this text is saying to them that, see, the home of God is among mortals. There are people today who are going to redo their entire life because it's New Year's Day. They're going to start making their bed. They're going to start meal prepping. They're going to get, Isaac goes, no, I like eating out. They're going to get a cleaning chart system, right? They're going to lose those 10 pounds. They're going to meditate. They're going to read more books. They might read their Bible. Amen. Amen. Amen, says Pastor Joe. And they're striving and they're racing without a map towards something in the distance that looks right. That looks like it's going to give them everything that they want, right? But they don't know how to get there. But the Bible tells us, friends, that we don't need to run towards something because God is with us. God was with us in the beginning. John 1, right today? In the beginning there was the Word, and the Word was God, and the Word was with God. God with us. God with us. God to be with us. There are thousands and thousands of people today, friends, who are going to be searching for something that you already have. You already have Jesus. I asked our little ones, and who knows what they're going to do. I asked them to draw, what would Highland look like in a year? Will there be cake? Joey, will there be flowers? I want to remind you that as we talk about revitalization, as we talk about the star in the distance, the Eiffel Tower in the distance, the well-formed life, 10 pounds less, mindful living, gentle parenting, ideal life in the distance, as we talk about church It's not in the distance, it's right here. And we don't need to run towards some image of what we think church is or what Highland should be, because it says that God is with us. And not only is he with us, that he is the beginning, he is Highland 1919, and he is Highland 2023. God is now, and he is making all things new, whether you want it or not. And so, friends, maybe don't place the Eiffel Tower in the distance and then, you know, 15 years later tell your father in front of people how you were lost in a very dangerous city in the middle of the night with 2 inches of ice and no map and no phone. It's okay. And
Mom's not here,
so it works out. Don't let her listen later. Yes. And maybe don't strive for this perfection. That at the end of this year, you're going to be on your own made new. Maybe let the table be your star. Let it be your guiding star. Let it be your direction, because the table belongs to Jesus. Jesus invites to his table all who are willing and able, who repent of their sins, who want to be in relationship. You don't have to change anything about yourself, because God makes all things new. You don't have to travel across a city. You don't have to travel across the world. You don't have to remake Highland into something that it is not. You just have to come to the table this year. And God's been at the table. And God is at the table. And that God will be with you at the table this year. Amen.
The table is ready. The feast is prepared. Let us stand as we're able and join in the prayer of great thanksgiving. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. Before the mountains were brought forth, or you had formed the earth from everlasting to everlasting, you alone are God. You created light out of darkness and brought forth life on the earth. You formed us in your image and breathed into us the breath of life when we turned away and our love failed. Your love remained steadfast. You delivered us from captivity, made covenant to be our sovereign God, and spoke to us through your prophets. And so with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy are you, and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ, in whom you have revealed yourself, our light and our salvation. By the baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church, delivered us from slavery to sin and death, and made with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit. On the night in which he gave himself up for us, he took bread, gave thanks to you, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When the supper was over, he took the cup, gave thanks to you, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." And so, in remembrance of these, your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here and on these gifts of bread and the cup. Make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world until Christ comes in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and your Holy Church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. Now, with the confidence of children of God, let us pray as Jesus has taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. We invite you to come to this, the table of the Lord, at the direction of the ushers. We have the prepackaged, if that's helpful for the time, and we also are glad to bring to you if you would like. Come now to this, the Lord's table.
invite you to stand as you are able and join with me in singing Hymn of Promise. Be the star of your life. May he be the direction, the path that you choose this year. May you know that God has been with you, that God is with you, that God will continue to be with you. Amen. Have a wonderful week.